during this time throughout 2020, I think in the late part of 2020, you began the Mastery podcast, and you had some guests on there such as Master Michael Chansey, your boy you talked about before, the guys from Ronin Athletics. That was also a pretty fun episode. And my favorite so far, you know which one I'm going to say, is the one with Olympus, Perez, formerly of WMAC Masters. So how rewarding has it been to be able to, I mean, you guys are all from different backgrounds or walks of life, but you're all bonded by martial arts in some way, shape, or form. So how rewarding has it been to be able to come together with these individuals and discuss your life experiences, your experiences training, all that stuff?
It's fantastic, man. You know, I probably get more no's than yeses, but it's been a pretty easy ride. Usually the people I talk to are like, you know, yeah, cool. So yeah, to be able to have that kind of pull is really nice. I can't say it's not. But again, I wanted to create a platform where I could sort of get this information out to people too. I like to talk about martial arts. So I wanted to create an environment that the people that also share that bond with me could also sit down and just have a conversation, be themselves, most importantly. So that's kind of the reason for doing that. And it's transformed, it's evolving. I just did one yesterday, which will hopefully drop tomorrow. It's really, really awesome. And that was a karate practitioner, black, female-owned karate practitioner in business. It was dope. We went overtime by quite a bit. So we just couldn't stop going. But that was kind of the thing. I bring on people where, you know what, they can be a repeat guest because, you know, last time we stopped here, let's pick up from where we left off. It's almost like having a long-term friend, like, you know, that you don't see as often. Like, you know, you can pick up the phone and just sort of get right back on call with them and do what you got to do. It's been a great journey. I see big things coming for it. And I'm just continuing to work at it. I don't ever listen to them. I don't like listening to my voice. So I literally make sure it's, you know, the right audio, the right video, post it, and then I move on to the next one, share it with everybody. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'm always thinking, while people are clapping for me, I'm thinking about the next thing. When I get to the finish line, I'm already on to the next challenge. So it's like, I'm graciously, you know, for everybody that's supportive. I'm happy that I'm getting the support I'm getting from everywhere. As far as Greece, as you've seen, so that's been a phenomenal journey. I mean, it's not like I ever thought I was going to be at this point in time or ever be able to create something like this. And it's still in its infancy, but again, I see really big things coming forward. So let's hope it continues.
Well, you're also a family man. As you said before, you got your boys, but you also are a girl dad.
I am.
I mean? Yeah. And true. I saw a post you put up a couple of days ago, and another thing you're dedicating yourself to is, you know, focusing more on the ladies and the young ladies and women in martial arts.
Yeah.
And how important is it of you to help build up that next generation of women in Taekwondo?
Super important. I've gotten a lot of success. I mean, I spent a lot of time sparring women too, in classes where you don't find very very many 6'4", 220-pound people in class. There's not a lot of them. So, you know, oftentimes I'd have to work with females, but then Master Martin, obviously, you know, taper it or wherever I was, be like, taper what you're doing. So I might handicap my power, but I still keep the speed 100%. You know what I mean? So I'm not making contact, you know, necessarily hitting them like a man per se, but there are things you learn from that. And I've learned a lot from females. I come from a largely female family. So I have a lot of that emphasis in my background, all successful women, business owners as well. So it's like, that's just kind of, I grew up that way. So now it feels like a natural transition now that I have one of my own. I want to invest time into it, you know, so. I think the days and years really do they fly by. I can't believe she's already 2 years old. And to me, it's a countdown because when she gets to a certain point, like we all do, we fly off. We leave the nest. We do what we gotta do. There will be a time where I see her, you know, maybe once a month, you know, as opposed to living with her every day. So when I catch myself being like, man, some of these days really hard or difficult. I'm like, all right. could be that she's 18, 19, 20, and I don't see her as often as I want to. So it helps me channel that again, that awareness, that external camera helps me be aware of like, yo, keep pumping information. And I love doing it. I love watching her growth. And she does Taekwondo too. She just doesn't wear a uniform. But she's already got her kicks. I've heard from other people. This is not me. I've heard from other people that her front kick looks dope. And I'm like, I might have something to do with that. But she's awesome, man. I teach her boxing too. We got a little single bag for her today. I saw, you know, and she's got perfect form for, I guess, a 2-year-old, but even better than a 2-year-old. It's like, you know, I think I got one complaint from her at her daycare where she, you know, she punched someone, but she punched them and brought it back. You know, it's like that only comes from the house. So I got in a little bit of trouble for that. But, you know, but I also, you know, teach her how to balance things too. You know, she sees me being active, which is good. I want her to see me constantly up and moving. I don't sit very much. This is the most sitting you'll see me do unless I'm sleeping. But I'm always moving around. And I want to leave something. I mean, for me, she's the most, my kids really the most important students I have, right? Not saying that the people I teach aren't, but my impact, my legacy will directly flow through them. And what they decide, you know, if they end up doing with their lives and how they live their lives will be based off of either my presence or my absence. And I don't want to be an absent father. That's not something that isn't even come to mind as an option, because again, it's a responsibility. And we talk about responsibilities, accountability. I'm a father now. How can I not be here? That's the job. The job is to be here. I mean, yes, I can't necessarily hang out with my friends like I used to. But the relationship changed, right? In a way where it's allowed me to be like, hey, I got to do this Monday to Friday, but Saturday we could chill. As long as I get the job done here at home. Starts at home. And I want to impart that information to them. I have so much to teach, you know, so, and not just Taekwondo stuff, not boxing, not just martial arts. I mean, life stuff. So I want to get all that information to them instead of complain, like I hear many people do about what their kids weren't able to learn. But it starts with you as the parent. Even if you work 2 jobs, 3 jobs, you got to spend that time. The job is on you. As Master Mars, it's on you. So I take that job very seriously. I just change hats, you know, but I think I'll probably take her to the park later. That's the goal.
Well, I want to be respectful of your time. So you're going to be on the 25th issue of Overtime Hustling Magazine. Yeah. You know, basically discussing your journey as you're doing here.
Yeah.
So when I know that's coming out, but I mean, what are your other goals? Not just throughout 2021, but, you know, ultimately as you continue this martial arts journey of yours.
Yeah. It's seeming like it's flowing in the direction of possibly opening up somewhere again. I have so many people I'm teaching now that I feel like I need a physical location. So I'm doing it organically. I kind of like the fact that I can do one-on-ones. I like privatizing this aspect. With a lot of people on the schedule, it's hard to do. It's a little easier to do if you have everybody coming to you at once, because then you're a little more effective with your time spending 1 hour with 10 people as opposed to spending 10 hours with 10 people. But for me, the love is still there. Even though I'll be extremely tired at the end of this day, I'll be tired because of something I love as opposed to something I don't want to do. And I learned from Jim Carrey, listening to him give a commencement speech, that, you know, he watched his father fail at something that, you know, he didn't want to do. So you might as well spend your time, you know, doing what you want to do. And even if you fail at that, you know, it's at least you failed at something that you love to do. You spend your time the right way. And that's kind of what it's about. So I've got the podcast, obviously the Mastery Podcast, that's on Spotify, YouTube, Apple, SoundCloud, that's everywhere. If you can't find it through Mastery, just type in, it's funny, you can just type in Chris Malarkey and I pop up, which is dope. I wanted to just be something really simple. So that's really cool. 6th episode should drop at some point this week, if not tomorrow. I've also got a website which has information on me, links to my social media. That's mastercm.net. That's an M that's in there. That's kind of been taken off. I just keep adding more pages to it. It's kind of scary how much I have, because all the photos I post are from my phone and my camera roll. It's just kind of like a snapshot of my life, but I'm telling it in a story, in a narrative form. So it's kind of, it's almost like those photos were like meant to be in the phone in this way. Like, and I don't know, like I'm not religious in any way, but it, or spiritual, but it's like, it's crazy how things happen when they happen. I'll say that. And I wouldn't even say karmatic. It's just really, I take a step back and I'm like, wow, how did that, for that, that two lane highway now turned into a five lane highway where I'm doing all this teaching, but then I also have merchandise, you know, I have my, one of my hats here has a little Scully, even though like the weather's just now breaking. But yeah, I've got stuff like this laying around and it's just cool because, you know, I'm a Batman fan. I don't know if you know, but I was always interested in the symbol and what it represented. And I feel I made something, you know, with my own name that carries a certain level of respect and a certain attitude that I feel like people should be proud to wear. So that's kind of my Batman way of doing things. But yeah, it's been, martial arts has been a pleasure to partake of. Watching my family, one of my sons is a black belt as well. He looked phenomenal on his test. Just gonna keep teaching. People just need to keep tuning in. You know, keep watching the podcast, pay attention to that website, mastercm.net, my Instagram, Master Chris Malarkey, if you want to find me. And you could, you know, you'll see the evolution. I think big things are coming around the corner.
All right, well, this has been awesome, and I can't wait to, you know, do this again, maybe a few months down the line. This
for sure.
Awesome, man.
Whatever you
great
want.
Great talking to you.
Yeah, same here, man. Thank you for having me.